Students, so in this video we will discuss about the sexual reproduction. Okay, in the previous video we have discussed about the asexual reproduction, but now in this video we will discuss the sexual reproduction. Okay, so what is sexual reproduction? So I have already given you the brief introduction of this. So in this reproduction, new individuals are formed from the two parents. So one organism cannot give rise to a new organism. So you need two parents, one male and one female. Therefore, sex is involved and there is a distinction between male and female sexes. Okay, we need one male and one female of that organism for sex to take place. For the fusion between the male and female gamete give rise to the female and male gametes. They contribute sexes and they fuse together to form a new organism. Okay, so they say that is the basic logic of sexual reproduction. So in this type of reproduction, the new individual are formed. They are not identical to their parents. They might have similarities, but they are not going to be exactly identical to their parents. So you have always distinguished your friend with their father. There will be any similarity between both of them, but there will be some dissimilarity also between them. Okay. So they are not purely identical to their parents. Some traits will be identical to their parents and some traits will be new ones. Okay. Now the question is, why sexual reproduction when you already have an asexual reproduction? What is the need of sexual reproduction? So what was the necessity? So to incorporate the variation in species, which in turn ensure survival of species. Variation which doesn't come in picture, because in asexual reproduction all the organisms are exactly identical to each other. So the new traits which come up over a period of time will not be present in asexual, but in sexual reproduction there will be a new traits which will be changes. That's how it can give rise to a new species. Okay, so this variation are very useful to ensure the survival of species, because we cannot we always give rise to a new species. So each individual is a species, had its own uniqueness and identity. You can always identify a particular person. If you talk about human being, you can always identify, because one is different from the other. Okay, so everybody is looking different from one another. Even in the siblings, they both are if two people, the two siblings are there, they all both are different from each other. Okay, so that much difference is there. So there are differences because of each particular individual. They have his own uniqueness and its own identity. That's why all individuals look different. Okay. Now the question is, how this entire thing will happen? So let us try to understand how exactly this DNA, that is the genetic material. By now we know genetic material. We are looking the information which is passed from one generation to another. So where this all located? See, our body is made up of several cells. So in cell you might be find a nucleus. So this is how it look like. Nucleus is like a chromatin threads. So these threads, if you look more closely, they are called chromosome, and these chromosome have genes, and genes are the units of inheritance. So you have genes for every specifically trait which is seen on your body. You have one gene for hair color, you have one gene for eye color, you have one gene for skin color, you have one gene for eye shape. So each and every trait you have a particular gene present on this chromosome. So what are these genes made up of? These contain the genetic protein called DNA. So basically these DNA is passed on from the parents to their offspring, and that is how the traits are passed from one generation to another. Okay, so I think with this you know where the DNA is located. Now why you should know the why during reproduction or how sexual reproduction helps in inheritance of traits from one generation to next. So this is where the DNA is located. So now what happens, inside the nucleus there you have this chromosome, and the number of chromosome is fixed in a particular species. For example, if you talk about human beings, there are 46 chromosomes which are present inside the nucleus. So this number is fixed. So all human beings will have same number of chromosomes. But if you talk about any other organism, that organism will have a different number of chromosomes. Now what happens during reproduction? So during reproduction, you need one male and one female. Now both of them will contribute one DNA copy during reproduction. Each parent will make a copy of their own DNA. So the mother will have its own DNA and father will have its own DNA. Okay, now both of them will create a copy of their own DNA, and these two DNA, the copies will combinedly form a daughter. So now suppose it is mother contribution, this is contribution, and this is what a father contribution. So both of this combine to form new DNA, and this new DNA will form the child. So this new DNA, it might may have some traits of mother, same traits of father, it will also same new traits. That is how the variation come in the community, and this DNA is present inside the child. So child is not formed directly. Once the fusion take place, that once the male and female gamete fuse together, a simple cell is formed which is called zygote. So this is what forms immediately after fertilization, and it will gradually grow to form a new human being. So inside a zygote, the cell baby is present which have some traits of father, some traits of mother, and that's how you carry off traits from one generation to next generation. And this is how the reproduction helps in inheritance. So I have tried to explain you in the short, because I don't want to get you into more detail, because you might not be able to understand what is exactly is, but that is how it is. Okay, now we will talk about gametes, because I have used this word so often. So gametes are the sex cells. These are specialized cells which is present inside our body, and they have half the number of chromosome as compared to the two other cells, and that is why they are specialized. As I was telling, in case of human being, all the cells inside our body, they have 46 chromosomes. So only exceptional are these sex cells. So these sex cells have half the number of chromosomes. That means they have 23 chromosomes. That is why when the father contribute one sex cell, and mother contribute one sex cell, the father sex cell will have 23 chromosome, mother sex cell will have 23 chromosome, and both will combine to form 46 chromosome, and that will be the cell of the child. So this is how it is. So gametes are also known as sex cells or germ cells. So germ cell is also used for gametes. So male and female gametes are identical to each other in some organism, but that is not necessary. Sometimes they are not identical to each other, sometimes they are very much different from each other. So those organisms in which they are identical, they are known as isogamy. Iso means same and gamete means gametes, that means identical gametes. So let us look at some example like green algae, Spirogyra. So they all have identical gametes, the male and female gametes. So they are called isogamy. Okay. So they are so identical so that you cannot distinguish between them. They are exactly similar to each other. So the male and female gamete, so this type of isogamy is seen in green algae like Chlamydomonas. Spirogyra. So these are some of the example where isogamy is seen. Okay. On the other hand, where there are some organisms where male and female gametes are completely different from each other, and this is known as heterogamy. Hetero means different, gamy means gamete. So here male and female gametes are so different from each other so that you cannot identify any similarity between each other. So in human beings, the male gamete and the female gamete is very much small as compared to the male gamete. On the other hand, the male gamete is motile. It can move from one place to another. Female gamete is non-mobile. It cannot move. So in human being, the male gamete is motile due to the presence of a tail-like structure. So this is the male gamete. So it has a tail in male gamete, so by which it can move, where in female gamete it cannot move, but it is quite big in size. It help in food storage. So that's how they both have different structure, they both have different function, they both have different features. So the male and female gametes are quite different from each other. So gametes are on human being is an example of heterogamy. So now we will see how fusion take place between male and female gamete and how the gamete will produce and how the zygote develop. So these are all things which we will study now. Okay. So let us talk about sexual reproduction in human being. So when we talk about sexual reproduction, in fact, when we talk about human being, sexual reproduction is the only mode, because asexual is not possible in human being. Okay. So that is why in human being, you cannot think of one person giving one babies. Okay. Giving birth to babies. For giving birth to a babies, a male and a female are required. So that is why we have very distinct female and male sexes. So now we will talk about male and female reproductive organs separately, and then we will look their function and we will see how exactly the male and female gametes are produced by the female and male organs respectively. But then in human being, it is not that every human being is capable of reproduce. So initially the baby is born, but baby is not able to give birth to a new baby. But after some time when they become then they are able to produce a baby after a certain age, and that age is known as puberty. So let us talk about puberty in human being. So we say that only after puberty he or she can be able to produce another one. That means now that person is capable for reproduction. Okay. So how do we define puberty? Puberty is that period during which the rate of general body growth slows down and reproductive tissue starts maturing. This is important. Now what happens? When a person or a human being is very small, maybe 1 or 2 year old, so that time the entire energy which is present inside the body that used up in growing, because that person has to grow. The kid might have to be, the weight pushes, the kid's height has to be increased, weight has to be increased, its weight has to be developed. So those are the growing things of the person in a person line, and that is how your parents provide you a nutritious food that so that you can grow. But after some time, your physical growth stops. Do you think that your height keep on increasing throughout of your life? You stop increasing it. Stop increasing after a certain age. Similarly, your weight stops increasing after a certain age. So the way your body developing or your brain is developing, all this stops after a certain age. So that time, the energy which was early being used for the physical growth is now used for a growth of the reproductive part. The reproductive tissue start utilizing their energy and they are start becoming mature. And that is when you enter into the reproductive phase of your life. So a very simple example, let us suppose when you are in a school, when you are in a junior classes, what is your basic job? Your basic job is to studying. So you spend all your energy in studying. So once you finish your studying and you are going to college, then what happens? Study is still your priority, but now your time or your energy is also consumed in another recreational activities also. Taking care of your looks, having some fun. So you also start spending time in another things also. Okay. So study is not first priority at that time for you. Okay. So in a similar way, in case of the energy which is present inside your body is technically is, it is also, or it is all used up for your body to grow. But once your body has grown, the same energy is utilized for the growth of your reproductive tissue. Now, puberty happens in different people in different ways, but there are some of the changes which are quite common in both, which are quite common same in all person, whether male or female, that is when they enter the puberty. Okay. So you can very easily distinguish between a girl who is very small or 10 years old or the girl that is 15 year old. By looking their physical appearance, you just make out the difference between both of them. So puberty is also known as adolescence. So this is that phase of your life between the childhood and the adulthood. So this is the intermediate phase. Okay, now what are the changes observed during puberty in male? So in case of male, some of the changes are thick hair growth under armpits and genital area, which was not present earlier, facial hair, appearance of beard and mustache. These are all signs of puberty. Change in voice. In case in male, you see the changes in voice. They have a cracky voice. The cracky voice comes up. The voice of a small kid who is 4 or 5 years and the voice of a boy who is 16 or 17 years old, you can you just identify the difference between the voices of both of them. So the voice quality changes. Occasional penis length larger. Penis is the primary, it is a male or reproductive organ, and sometimes occasionally there is an enlargement of penis take place. And now how this happens and how, and we will talk about in reproductive part, okay, about this. Now some of the changes which observe in female puberty are starting of menstruation cycle. So what is menstruation cycle? It is a cycle which takes place periodically every 28 days, and in this cycle there is a lot of bleeding from the vagina, and it lasts for 3 to 4 days in every month. As long as this menstruation cycle, the female is said to be in a reproductive phase. Okay, she is capable of reproducing. So this is cycle start when the female is about to 11 to 14 years of old, that means in the age of puberty. So it all start around that time, and as the female grows old, somewhere around 45 or 50, this cycle stops. So you can say that female cannot reproduce before the menstruation cycle start, and also she cannot reproduce when it stops. Okay. So start of menstruation cycle is known as, is an important indication of puberty. Now the second thing is breast enlargement. So as a girl grows up, you can see the enlargement of breast also. Hair growth under armpits and genital area. In the female also you see a lot of hair growing in the reproductive part or also in the armpit. Okay, so in next video we will discuss about the male reproductive organ and how male gamete is produced. I hope all this concept, you all understand these all these concepts, and if you have any problem, you just ask me in your WhatsApp group. Thank you, class.